This is Molly from Book Babblers. Today I am going to do my top 10 favorite books from 2018. These are in no particular order. I read 37 books and these are just my top 10 favorite. My first favorite book was Educated by Tara Westover. It's a memoir. Westover grew up in a very strange household. Her parents were survivalists. Her dad was a religious fanatic, and they homeschooled their kids, and it wasn't a good homeschooling education. The Westover family had a lot of tragic things happen. It was one disaster after another. Tara explains how she gets out of this family dynamic by getting an education, going to college, and I don't want to tell too much of the story, but it is really fascinating. My second favorite book is The Fault in Our Stars by John Green. You guys, if you have not listened to this on audiobook, even if you've read the book, go listen to it on the audiobook. It was so great. This is a young adult temporary novel. It is about two kids that are struggling with their cancer diagnoses and they fall in love. It's beautiful, it's funny, it's hilarious. It had me laughing from the very first chapter to the very last chapter. I highly recommend it. I especially recommend listening to the audiobook. My third favorite book is LMNOP by Mark Dunn. This is a brilliant book. It is about words and the freedom of speech and the dangers of totalitarianism. This book is set on a fictitious island, the island of Nolop, and as the government starts to remove letters from the language, the writer, Mark Dunn, starts to remove letters from the book. It's brilliant. And so by the end of the book, you are reading the English language minus 20 letters. And it's fascinating how he is able to get the message across using less letters. I highly recommend it. It is a fun read. It's a quick read. It is a great book club book because it offers a lot of material for discussion. My fourth favorite book was The Magnolia Story by Chip and Joanna Gaines. I had only watched Chip and Joanna's TV show once or twice before I read this book, so I actually wasn't a fan of theirs, and I didn't really know what I was getting into. This was a book club pick, and I wasn't excited because I didn't want to read about celebrities that I knew nothing about. But I listened to the audiobook, and this is one I would definitely recommend for the audiobook because Chip and Joanna are the narrators and it's fun to hear their voices and they go back and forth doing the narration. And I think that adds a lot to it. I think that Chip and Joanna are really inspirational and it's interesting to hear their love story and how they grew and how their empire grew and how it started. And I think they are inspiring and they have great values. I would just highly recommend this book. It's a fun, quick read. Okay, my fifth favorite book is Gone with the Wind by Margaret Mitchell. Okay, I was afraid when I got into this book because it is a beast of a book. It is really thick. And I thought it would just be a lot of descriptions of lovely countryside, but it wasn't. It was really plot driven, really character driven. Every word meant something to the plot, to the characters. I loved all the characters in the book, especially Scarlett O'Hara and Rhett Butler. They are very complex characters. You see the good and the bad in them. Sometimes you want to tear your hair out and scream and yell at them. I highly recommend this book. I would say out of all the books I read, it was my number one favorite. My sixth favorite book is What Alice Forgot by Leanne Moriarty. This is the first book I've read by Moriarty and I actually really enjoyed it. It was one that I started and kind of got sucked into it and couldn't put it down. I would say the last half of the book was my favorite. What really surprised me about this book is that through the plot, it seemed to show the importance of a relationship between a husband and wife and sisters and friends, and how relationships can easily fall apart just through simple miscommunication or misunderstandings. My seventh favorite book was The Blue Castle by L.M. Montgomery. This is the first book that I had read by L.M. Montgomery, and I loved it so much. It was such a delightful read. It's a cute love story. L.M. Montgomery is known for her Anne of Green Gables series. The Blue Castle is one of her few adult books, and it was a clean romance. It was such a fun read. It's a quick read. I highly recommend this for Valentine's Day, just to read a cute love story. So my eighth favorite book of the year was Anne of Green Gables. My mom gave this to me when I was a young kid, and so many years later, I finally got around to reading it, and I read it because I loved The Blue Castle so much. Anne of Green Gables was such a fun read. Anne is such a fun character. She's imaginative, she's mischief, she's got a fiery streak in her. She can get really angry and mean, but she can also be really sweet. My favorite thing about her was her love for nature and just the simple pleasures of life. And I felt like a kindred spirit with her in that regard, because I really do love the simple beauties in life, like a flower or a tree or a pretty cloud in the sky. And she was such a fun character. I would highly recommend reading Anne of Green Gables if you just want to have a smile on your face. I'm an adult. I enjoyed reading it, even though this is considered a children's book. My ninth favorite book this year was Angus, Thongs, and Full Frontal Snogging by Louise Renison. This is so funny. Georgia Nicholson, I believe is her last name. The character in the book is hilarious. She has really witty humor. She gets herself into funny scrapes, and you can't help but laugh throughout the whole book and giggle. If you want a good laugh and a little bit of irreverent humor, this is a great young adult book. My 10th favorite book this year was The Coldest Girl in Cold Town by Holly Black. This is a vampire story. It's definitely not Twilight type of vampire story, although there is a little bit of a chemistry between a human and a vampire. I don't want to get into it too much. It's a dystopian future where vampires have been quarantined into certain cities, and so it's really hard to get in and out of these cities where vampires dwell. It's creepy, it's a little romantic, it's a little violent. I liked it. I hope you enjoyed this video. Stay tuned for my worst videos of 2018. I'm excited to share what reads I did not like, which ones I could not finish. Thanks for watching, Book Babblers. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos.